Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to the vlogs. First one of 2022. Roll the intro. You birthed me, Brooklyn, you nursed me. School me with hard knocks, better than Berkeley. They said you murked me by the time I was 21. That shit. Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to Life Advice. Please like, please comment, please subscribe, all that sort of good stuff. Really helps the fast growing the channels and all our channels, to be honest. So really looking forward to 2022. Had a couple weeks off up in Byron and Gold Coast, but it was fun. We had a really great trip. Get to know the partners a little bit better. A bit of dramas there as well, so you probably hear about those on the podcast. But yeah, Life Advice is back. A couple of my goals that I've set this year is to be a little bit more healthy in terms of exercising. In terms of cooking at home, I think last year I would have cooked at home between like 10 and 15 times max. Just want to be on a bit of a healthier buzz and transform and be a healthier person. Hopefully that helps me be a better leader, a better business person, and therefore YKTR can grow. Really excited about this year. I've set some pretty ambitious goals for YKTR and YKTR Sports, and I feel like we've got a pretty good team to do it as well. Obviously, Scopes really started to grow over the past couple of years. Simi's probably one of our leading talents at the moment. Lukey's my guy, and he's looking to grow as well. Jackson comes back in a couple of weeks. Caleb, we brought him on, and he's doing really good things. And Chico's doing his food content as well. How do we level it up? And that's what that trip away was about. I was sort of just hanging there on my own and thinking about ways that we can grow. So I'm excited for it all. So we're going to be on camera, whether we're good or bad or we fuck up. We'll be the first ones to front up and show you guys as well. I think last time I showed you guys here, I had a flatmate. I'm just living here on my own. I built out a little gym in my house. I call it the Wellness Center. So obviously if you follow me on my stories, you would have seen this. But just got the rubber mats, a couple dumbbells. Got a few more dumbbells and kettlebells in there. Got the assault bike, got a bench with a dirty t-shirt on it, and got my two boys. These guys motivate me the most. I've said this plenty of times, but this is just going to be more so about my personal life, things I'm into outside of YKTR. I know within YKTR you just hear me talk about business. I'm like business, all that sort of shit, but I'm into a bunch of different things, eh? I love furniture, obviously into clothes, into food. I eat out a lot, eat at a lot of cool places. So I'm gonna show you guys these things, obviously trying to get a little bit healthier, and also gonna start the cooking at home journey as well. So we'll never be as good as Chico at cooking, but yeah, I'm just gonna give it a crack. Alright guys, what's up? Saturday morning. Decided to clean out my whole closet. Want to start 2022 fresh, and obviously we're 80% of YKTR, but just heading into the city now. Going to show you where I'm going to top up with all my basics. Usually I shop a little bit weird, like I buy in threes. So once I get something that I like, I'll just buy like three black t-shirts, three white t-shirts, three grey t-shirts, and then I'll just sit there. And then I'm just going to redo my whole wardrobe just so it's all in place as well. So just heading towards the city now. Bit of a workout this morning. Haven't eaten yet, so I'll grab some food in the city and I'll see you guys in there. All right, back at our mask bullshit. Just here in the gallery is a pretty cool store here called InQ. If you watched the vlog probably from about a year ago, went to the head office, got to meet the owners and stuff like that. Two Kiwi guys, Carhartt store there, we'll check that out. But they got a really cool store here down in the gallery, so gonna go check it out. Won't be allowed to film in there, that's for sure, but hopefully they put some cool stuff. I just seen a couple of things in InQ. I'll walk up a little bit later, but I kind of just do a big fat lap and come back around. But starving, haven't eaten today, trying to get back on the intermittent fasting. So that's like a chicken katsu with the curry on top of the rice underneath. Really good. Every time I sort of come to the galleries, which is in Sydney City, and I want something quick, I'd be here. So it's really good. All right, here we go here. Obviously got the deep fried chicken. Got the curry there and a bit of rice. Yo, so just got back from town now, got a bunch of clothes. I'm gonna show you how I shop. This is just preference, how I like to do things. E.g. to buy socks all the same color so I don't have to mix and match. I rock about three different styles of socks. I rock a black short, lots of gray socks like this, so they suit all my white shoes and shit like that. And a gray low sock as well. So when I shop, I will just buy like 10 or 20 of those each. Therefore, like if I lose a sock, I could just match them up for another one. In terms of basic tees, obviously I run YKTR, so 80% of my closet is always going to be YKTR. Helps that you get it for free as well, so grateful for that. But in terms of basics, in terms of everyday rocks when I don't want to rock YKTR, this is the best tee you can cop. It is called a crew neck short sleeve t-shirt. Basically my favorite t-shirt I do. So they're 20 bucks, so I buy three of each color, so that'd be 60 bucks. And I get all the essentials. I get my whites, I get my blacks, I get my navies, and I get my grays as well. So it's like that. They all sit in my basic straw. In terms of fit, they rock like a little bit oversized. I rock an XL in these, but it's got a bit of an oversized vibe to it as well. So this is literally my favorite tee ever, ever. 20 bucks, you can't lose. Really good material, thick. It's cotton. It's got kind of a rough hand feel to it as well, much like our oversized ones. It's not as heavy as this. This is like 260 GSM. I'll say this is roughly about 220. But man, they're solid. Like I wash them, I dry them. They stay solid. But I just like to top them up every couple months as well. So that's how I shop. I get basics. I get my grays, my navies, my blacks, my whites. These are my every single days. So you can rock this with anything. You can have a vibey short if you want. Rock them with jeans. It could be a mad undershirt. You can layer them over the top. When I'm not rocking YKTR. Just got a couple ACG things, which is Nike's all condition gear. Really basic stuff. So be winter in a couple months. Got this sort of khaki base hoodie. Pretty cool. 100% cotton, a little bit oversized. Got an XL. Really like the feel of it, like the fit. Khaki color, white drawstrings, very minimal. Kind of over the white drawstring phase, but it kind of brings out the little Nike tick there as well. And that's tiny as well. Cop this hoodie as well. Same brand, obviously Nike. I love the digital print on this as well. So pretty cool hoodie. Most hoodies just have the single stitching down there. They've gone for like a sort of a mohawk seam style on it. But yeah, a bit more vibier. Love the colors of it. ACG. Pretty cool arm extension out of Nike. I really like it. It's a ThermoFit. And got a pair of shorts as well, but they're kind of just plain black. Oh, got a plain Nike tee as well. Just want to mix up the basics. I don't rock too much vibey shit. I'm all about basics. So yeah, got these shorts from NQ, which is their in-house brand. Cool detailing, double zippers on the back with the rubber seams on it. Just a nice little basic short, to be honest. Love the detailing on this as well. Alright guys, currently Sunday. Really looking forward to getting back to work tomorrow. The full team's back in. Jackson comes back on the 20th and Simic actually comes back on Tuesday. So we're looking forward to sort of setting some goals individually with those guys. I want to be surrounded with people that are getting smarter, not people that are staying the same. And obviously when you lead a company, you want those people to come with you as well. So really important for us at YKTR that we all have goals. Duck back into the city. Much like t-shirts, I kind of buy in bulk. The Daily Laws, Robert Greene. 5 Dysfunctions of a Team. I've listened to the audiobook, but want to reread it and sort of highlight and mark all the good parts. 12 and a half, Gary V's book. I listened to this already, but same again. I usually go through, bend pages and highlight shit. That's just how I do it. Creative Inc. Creativity Inc. Magnetic Stories, something built about brand or storytelling. Principles of Success, Ray Dalio, really good author. Staring Down the Wolf, this is a book on leadership. And Will Smith's autobiography. Now this is kind of like a full circle moment for me. I listened to a YouTube clip probably about 12 years ago, and he was the guy that actually inspired me to start reading. And the thing that inspired me was he's very unassuming. Like I just anticipated that he'd be a certain type of way just because he was like a comedian or a rapper. And I listened to him, and he was the first guy that I really paid attention to that was super engaging with everything that he was talking about. And he recommended a book called The Alchemist by Paulo Coelho. And I remember reading that book, and it actually started my reading journey. And the thing I loved about Will Smith, he's very unassuming. And I love when I'm able to surprise people by doing that, like a lot of people see me. If you don't know me, you haven't followed the journey, you just look at me like, oh, he's a kid from Tokoroa, he's an islander, he's never been to university. He's just a footy player, he's just a dumb footy player. Like, what's he doing talking about businesses and stuff like that? So I get a kick out of being unassuming, but it's built off the back of this guy. And it's built off the back of reading a fuckload of books. And the reason why I can stand here today is because like I've read over maybe 170, 180 books. We'll be closing in on 200 now. And it's all come from reading. Like the reason why I started a business is because I was reading books about business people, and I was over football at the time. And I was actually over the conversations that I was having with him in football circles. We were just talking about like girls and benders and gambling. And don't get me wrong, that shit was fun, but I kind of just got bored of that shit. I just wanted to like level up and do things. And reading was a big part of why I'm staying here today. So yeah, make sure you guys are always trying to level up through reading. Obviously that leads into self-education, that led into online courses, that led into me launching my own online courses as well. So yeah, I'm pretty excited to get through all those books there. Currently cutting up a vlog, but looking forward to getting back to work and trying to build these dreams up as best as I can. So yeah, that's a wrap. Looking forward to getting first day of work tomorrow. I'm going to be cracking the whip straight away on the boys. So want to get rolling. We've had 3-4 weeks off and had a pretty good holiday. So really keen to get rolling and back into things. Thanks for supporting myself. Thanks for supporting YKTR and all the boys that come with it. Hope you guys kill it 2022. Hope you guys got some goals and you're smashing them out. I'm gonna be documenting all my goals, and hopefully you guys get something out of it, whatever it is. I don't know why you support this channel, but hope you guys get something positive out of it. So see you guys, ready to roll this year. Later. She see money all around me. I look like I'm the man.